Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom here. Okay, this is another part in my ongoing Metal Gear Solid 3 1911 build. And, well, the response from the first video was unbelievable, I've got to say that. I've had no end of people sending me links to pictures and so forth of naked snakes, not snakes, but naked snakes. I don't know why that he calls himself Naked Snake, but there you are. Of his gun or 1911 that's used in the game. I've also had a kind chap has actually done a video for me. His name is, well, his YouTube handle name, whatever you want to call it, avatar name, is iTzArMs, which is little I, big T, little Z, big A, little R, big M, little S. You know who you are. Many, many thanks for that, and for the links to the pictures you've sent as well. Also, another chap on here, LifesDespirations, he sent me some other details and stuff, and some links, I think, or whatever. He sent me some bits and bobs. It's trying to keep track of all the info that I've been getting. I had no idea you guys really like your blooming computer game weaponry, which I suppose is obvious because you guys are using them or whatever online and in games or whatever all the time, so you start to get a connection to them. So yeah, thanks ever so much guys for that, really, really appreciate it. Yeah, I can't say anything greater than that. Now then, how far have I got? Not very far at the moment. I'm purely waiting on details and pictures, so as I say, I'm collating, getting bits and bobs together to make sure that this goes right. Two things, well actually three things that I've actually worked on so far. One, as you can see, is the grip safety. I've shaped it, made it exactly like the game one, or as near as I can get. It is slightly different to a real steel duckbill version. For some reason in the game version this is a lot thinner. I think it's to do with the graphics on the game, I'm not sure, but it does look slightly different to a real steel. So I umdenard, I want to get this identical to the game version, so I've done it slightly longer. And it definitely does not catch the hammer. I've already tested it in a frame and yeah, it doesn't catch, so that's pretty good. After grinding it all and everything else, as you can see, I've sprayed it silver. I couldn't obviously use a silver one. I haven't got the money at the moment. This is all from spare parts or bits that have been kindly donated, which I'm always very, very thankful for. So that's the grip safety done. The other thing, which I'm not sure if I actually had done in the previous video or not, but I've started work on the thumb safety. Now, this is an ambi thumb safety. I know, it's meant to be a single thumb safety. It will be. This whole section on this side will be cut away, and the end will be rounded and polished and glued, because this obviously is in two halves, so that will be glued to that. But as you can see, the silver one on this side has been polished, and it's silver anyway. It's from the TM silver high capper. So as you can see, I've started to cut an angle the thumb safety in the weird design that is in the game, as near as I can, and it don't look too bad. I'm quite happy with that. It's a lot thinner, as you can see, than the other side. I believe one of you commented that it looked like the Ed Brown thumb safety. Well, essentially the TM high capper one is a copy of the Ed Brown, so it's pretty much the same deal. So there we go, so that's that. I've managed to get hold of a silver Garda serrated mag catch. I can't get a checkered, I just have not got the funds at the moment. So I've gone for the Garda silver one. I'm sure you guys will let me off on one little faux pas in regards to accuracy, but that's as near as I can get for the moment with the funds that I've got available. I've still not done any work to the trigger. The frame, all I've done with the frame is filled in the markings where they're required, and that's that, so there's no other real things I have to do to that. The slide is yet to have the engraving done and anything else done to it, so that will still be to come. Not sure if I showed you in the previous video, but the outer barrel. It's a standard MEU black outer barrel. The reason being, it will take the Tanya Cobra 14mm thread adapter for a silencer on the front. Barrel bushing is a Night Warrior Silver TM standard barrel bushing. So, yeah, managed to get that out of my spares. Hammer, as I mentioned before, is a standard combat 4.3 hammer, which I've just polished down. I'm going to be using a high kappa blowback housing. I managed to get a spare. I've had a bit of a swap around on parts from other guns and so forth in order to be able to make this. So a couple of my other guns have, well, been stripped in order to make this one. So, yeah, things are getting tough, but I've managed to do it. So I've managed to get the blowback housing. But I've also already made the rear sight. Now, a lot of you are going to go, oh my god, it's nothing like the one in the game. Hopefully this sunlight will not be too strong that you can't work out what it looks like. But it's still angled as per the 4.3. It's the only one I can actually use in regards to this blowback housing. So, I mean, one chap, I'm not sure who it was now, sent me a picture via email or whatever, which shows what looks like a hiney sight that has had concave bits ground out of the sides of it. Technically, that's not correct to the game version. It's the nearest that you can get real steel, I suppose, but it's not technically correct. I want to get this as correct as I can. Now, the one in the game is a very, very odd design. It's quite a long sight as well. I would say it's almost sort of Bomar length, instead of 4.3 length, but it is concave on either side, as you can see from my version. It's concave towards the front, and it's got a very sharp angle at the front, but that's it. The whole rest of it is flat topped. Well, obviously I can't do that with the parts that I've got available, so I've done the best I can, which is, as you hopefully can see, I've concaved either side of that sight, and I've sort of tried to angle out as much as I can at the front and leave this as shallow as possible, but also keep a flat top to it. It actually looks a little bit like the Western Arms one, which is, ugh, yeah, it shouldn't be like that, I know, but it's the best I can do with the parts I've got available. So again, a little sort of a faux pas there, considering the mag catch as well, but it's the only way I can do it at the moment, but hopefully you'll forgive me that if the rest turns out as I hope it will. Everything else is pretty much standard. Grips are standard. I've yet to do the angled cutout. I have no idea I'm going to do that. That will be very tricky. I may even use some cheap wood grips, checkered wood grips off of eBay or something, and just see if I can pick those up, but we'll just have to wait and see. And that's pretty much it. So, as I say, this is part two. Again, many, many, many thanks to all those who have sent me information with regards to this particular pistol build. I'm always open to any information that you can give me on any of 1911s or whatever that are out there. It all goes in my files. My files are rather extensive. It now fills up pretty much three A4 steel binders. So I'm building up more and more pictorial information and detailed information as well, background histories and so forth, which I always like, as you know, a bit of a sponge for history on weapons. So I'm doing that as well. But so any information you've got is always, always helpful to me. I'm very, very thankful to those two chaps and others who have given me other information that obviously I should be mentioning your names, but it's trying to write all your names down and remember them over the time. But I'm sure you'll comment below anyway. So thanks guys to everybody out there who supported my channel on all other subjects that I've done over the years. Don't think you're not mentioned or whatever, so you're forgotten. You're not. Your information has been used. It's you guys are what make my channel worthwhile, really, is the feedback that I get, which is pretty much 99% positive. I mean, yeah, there are occasional haters, whatever, you will get them. But overall, you guys have been phenomenal. You really have. You've stuck with me through thick and thin. Sometimes I upload videos like once in a blue moon, and then another time, hopefully, you know, I'm pretty regular. Like usually, I mean, up till recently, it was like two videos every week. But due to personal issues and life getting in the way and so forth, things have sort of dropped off lately. But that's just how it goes, as you all know, I should imagine. So, but yeah, it's, as I say, I thanks ever so much for sticking with my channel. And as I say, this all comes out of my own pocket. That's why I'm always, you know, glad of donations or whatever. I know some people put email addresses and so forth on there. Channel pages saying donate here and da 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 for money and all sorts. As far as I'm concerned, I'm not interested in sort of, you know, outright blatantly asking for stuff. I'm not like that. As far as I'm concerned, if you've, you know, feel that you've got something that might be of benefit to this channel, to getting projects done, then great, you know, contact me by PM. But at the end of the day, you know, it's up to you guys. I'm not worried either way. Parts, if they can't be got, you know, it will take a little bit more time, that's all, but they usually do turn up in the end. So yeah, so as I say, I thank you for your subscribing, for your patriotism to the channel, and for obviously watching my videos, which seem to be the only ones on YouTube that are fairly close up, in-depth, detailed. I've started to actually have a really good look now at what others are doing out there. Some of the videos are very, very good, and I've actually put them on my favourites. So if you look right down the bottom of my channel page, you'll see my favourites, and there's quite a few 1911 videos and so forth. A lot of them are real steel, I hasten to add, but there are a few airsoft ones on there which I feel are deserving of including. And are not just guns being got out of box and what am best gun and all that, which personally I find very, very boring. But, you know, it's a start for some of you. If you're new to YouTube or whatever, fair enough. You know, from small acorns, large oak trees grow, which this channel is essentially a case in point. But, yeah, so coming back to video content and stuff like that, a lot of you guys are very, very you know, intuitive as to what to put in those videos, so I've included them in my favourites. So if ever you're not sure, or you can't find anything to answer your question on my videos, please, please look at the favourites on other people's videos, because they are good. They cover things that I haven't done yet, or forgotten, or whatever. Have a good look. They are worth checking out. Anyway, enough of me waffling on. With regards to this gun, it's now ongoing. I'm now deeply into it. many thanks to you guys that have given me the information. If you've got any other bits and bobs that you can possibly give to me in regards to information or even parts, whatever, please by all means do so, but it's entirely up to you. You know, don't feel pressured or anything like that. As far as I'm concerned, you know, I just do this sort of as a laugh, really. Well, not as a laugh, I love the 1911, but at the end of the day, it's all good fun. That's what I class it as, and the day I stop enjoying it, the day I will give it up. So there you go. Anyway, I'm going to be waffling on here for no reason. I have no idea. I think it must be the sun. We don't often get sun in Britain, but there we are. We've actually got a bit of sun. So yeah, I should be out enjoying it, but there we are. I, you know, sacrifices I make for you guys. So yeah, anyway, so there you go. That's another part in my Metal Gear Solid pistol build. Hopefully the next part will have a little bit more done. Can't guarantee what, but hopefully it will sort of evolve as it carries on. Anyway, thanks guys for watching. Remember guys, stay sharp, but please stay safe. This is LaZouche Custom, so bye for now.